put your fingers high. One time, cause we made it. One time for the greatest. One time for the haters. Gone, put your fingers high. One time if you ballin'. The game keep on crawling. They wanna see us fallin'. But we gon' put them high. One time, cause we made it. One time for the greatest. One time for the haters. Gone, put your fingers high. One time if you ballin'. The game keep on crawling. They wanna see us fallin'. But we gon' put them high.
Your girl Likah, and I'm back for my next video. Y'all know the season did just start. We are going to talk about opening night and everybody debuts with a new team. But before we get started, we got to talk about Dwayne Wade. Y'all know Dwayne Wade just signed a contract with TNT, so we're going to see him on Tuesday nights, and he's going to be a sports anchor with Shaquille O'Neal, and I'm happy about that because y'all know he retired last year, so we're not going to see him on the court no more. So at least I can see him on my TV. Y'all know that's my favorite player, so I'm very excited. Moving on to opening night, y'all know we had the Lakers and the Clippers and the Raptors and the Pelicans. So we're going to talk about the first game. The first game was the Raptors and the Pelicans. The Raptors did take the W in overtime. The final score was 122-130. Y'all know Pelicans did just pick up Lonzo Ball, Brandon Ingram, and Josh Hart and Zion Williams. But y'all know Zion Williams is out for 6 to 8 weeks. So they put in Deion Favors. I don't know his first name. Favors in as the center. So Lonzo Ball, he had 8 points. Josh Hart had 15. And Brandon Ingram had 22. They had Josh Hart come off the bench, and then Lonzo Ball and Ingram start. Siakam for the Raptors, he had 34 points and 18 rebounds. And then Van Fleek had 34 points. And then y'all know Lowry just signed a one-year deal with the Raptors. He had 22 points. The game did start a little slow, but it did pick up at the end. The final score before it went into overtime, it was 117. They let Powell take a shot, he missed it, and then when it went into overtime, the Raptors just took off and won the game. So we all know the Raptors are our champions. You don't really hear it as much as you heard the Warriors were our champions. I don't know why. I guess since Leonard is not there no more, I feel like people would not really focus on the Raptors anymore. But I feel like that's fucked up. The Raptors is a good team with or without Leonard, if you ask me. They almost made it to the finals a couple times when LeBron was in the East. That's the only reason they didn't make it, if you ask me. But they are champions, and y'all need to respect that. So, yeah. Moving on to the Clippers and the Lakers. The Clippers did take that W. Y'all know this is the debut for Leonard and Paul George, which y'all know Paul George is not coming back to November. The final score was 112-102. Leonard had 30 points, and y'all know Lou Williams, this was his team before they came along, but I think they did start him. Even though he is the sixth man, he had 21 points. And then y'all know Anthony Davis and LeBron. This is their first game actually playing a real game together. So AD had 25 points and 9 rebounds. And then LeBron had 18 points and 10 rebounds. So he had a double-double, his first double-double of the season. Even though they took the L. But if I had to pick a player of the game, it would have to be Danny Green. Because Danny Green, he came like he was doing the thing in the third quarter. He was 6 from 6 from the field goal, like he was making threes, and that was the person to get the ball to in the third quarter. Y'all know Kuzma is out for his foot, and then Rondo is out. I feel like Lakers have a lot of big men. I feel like they need more shooters, if you ask me. I know they're playing LeBron as the point guard or the shooting guard. I feel like they need a little guy. They have a lot of big men. They got Dwight, they got AD, they got McGee, they got LeBron. Like, they got a lot of big men. So, and Cousins, even though Cousins is not there, but they got a lot of big men. But they took that L. So moving on, y'all know OKC just picked up Chris Paul. Sadly, OKC played the Jazz in that opener. We did take that L. The final score was 95-100, thanks to Steven Adams, if you ask me. But Chris Paul did do a good job in the first game. He played 30 minutes. He had 22 points, and he had 8 rebounds. Y'all know the Jazz did pick up Michael Conley. Michael Conley only had 5 points, but he played 27 minutes. He was good on the Grizzlies, so I feel like that was a good fit for the Jazz. But we took that L. We are a young team. I feel like we do have some shooters on our team, but I feel like Steven Adams wanted us to lose, basically. If you ask me, he was letting Devon Mitchell shoot over him. He was letting Devon Mitchell get his own rebound. It's just like, I wasn't understanding. He was giving me a headache. Then he was mad that we lost. It's just like, it's your fault. But we took that L. Hopefully Chris Paul is not there too much longer. But I feel like Steven Adams, he's playing horrible so he can get a trade. So we'll see how that shit goes. Moving on. Y'all know the Celtics played the 76ers. Y'all know the Celtics did pick up Kemba Walker. And then the 76ers did pick up Al Horford and Josh Richardson. Y'all know Josh Richardson is from Miami and Al Horford is from the Celtics. Kemba only had 12 points and Al Horford had 16 and Josh Richardson had 17. I think Josh Richardson did start. He was great on Miami. I don't know why Miami got rid of Josh Richardson. He was really good. But the final score was 93-107. The Celtics were winning at first, but I don't know. They just they started messing up in the fourth quarter. Was no communication, was no defense. I don't know. They gave up, if you really ask me. I know Jaylen Brown did just sign a contract. He signed a 4-year deal for $115 million. They did offer him $90 million, but he didn't take it. I don't know why he thinks he's worth more, but I feel like Celtics think that he's worth more. I feel like that's a lot of money. Jaylen Brown is not worth that. I could see if it was Jason Tatum, but oh well, he got what he wanted. So, but they still took that L. So moving on, y'all know Clippers played the Warriors for the Warriors debut. The Warriors did lose. Y'all know they did pick up D'Angelo Russell, but Klay Thompson is out for the rest of the season, so it's just Curry and D'Angelo Russell. The Warriors did lose 5 players, so I feel like they are going to be on a little weak side. It's basically new people, young people, so I feel like they're really not going to get far. The final score was 141-122. D'Angelo Russell did have 20 points. He did make the first 10 shots for the Warriors, and Steph Curry did have 23 points, but I feel like honestly the Warriors is not what the Warriors used to be. So they lost Iguodala, KD, Livingston, a lot of people, so they're not going to get far. Moving on, y'all know Kyrie went to the Brooklyn Nets. Him and KD did go there, and DeAndre Jordan. But Kyrie, he had 50 points, he had 7 assists, 8 rebounds, and he played 38 minutes. He played awesome, but they still took the L. He tried to take the game winner, he tripped up, he failed, and he tried to shoot it, he missed it. He was very upset. I would be upset too if I was playing 2K and I had 50 points and we lost the game. Like, I felt his pain. Like, that shit felt like I did all this shit for nothing. But he was the 7th player in Nets history, Brooklyn history, to make 50 points in the season opener. So I mean, he did make history even though they still lost, but I feel your pain. They played the Timberwolves. The final score was 126-127. You know, Karl Anthony Towns is my favorite young player. He had 36 points and 14 rebounds, I believe. He is a good player, and it was a good game. I really wish Kyrie would have made that shot. Like, if he would have made that shot, I feel like that would have been the new Lillard shot. But he didn't, so. And y'all know KD's out for the rest of the season, so he's basically by himself. But I mean, he got DeAndre Jordan, but DeAndre Jordan's not what he used to be, so we'll see how far the Nets go. Y'all know the Rockets played the Bucks on their season opener. The Rockets did lose. It was 111-117. Y'all know they did pick up Westbrook for Chris Paul. Westbrook did have 24 points and 16 rebounds. Harden and Westbrook did get into it in the first quarter. Like we said, and like we all thought, this shit wasn't gonna, you know, they was gonna be fighting. But they are passing the ball. Surprisingly, Harden is passing the ball. Surprisingly, Westbrook is passing the ball. They're making good plays. I'm surprised by that. they aren't doing too bad. Harden did have 14 assists and he had 19 points. Giannis had 30 points. It was a good game. Rockets were winning at first, but they did let the Bucks come back and win. I don't know how, but they did. So Rockets took that L, and I'm not mad about it. I'm happy because I know when OKC lose, Rockets got to lose, right? Moving on, y'all know Miami. They played the Grizzlies for their opener. Y'all know they picked up Tyler Hero, Jimmy Butler, Kendrick Nunn. But y'all know Jimmy Butler didn't play in the opener. He just had a baby girl, so he couldn't be there. So it was Tyler Hero and Kendrick Nunn. Tyler Hero, y'all know he is from the round one and the 11th pick. And then Kendrick Nunn, he is from the G League. Combined points, they had 38 points. Hero had 14. Kendrick had 24. They both started. And yeah, we took that W. So I'm happy about that. I hope when Jimmy Butler come back, we can all get along. Hopefully he don't have no problems with nobody and we just get this W. Y'all know that's my second team because Dwayne Wade, so I'm rooting for Miami. Moving on, y'all know the Pistons played the Pacers. The final score was 119-110. Y'all know Blake Griffin is out, so he wasn't there. And then they have kind of Victor from the Pacers. He is out from January injury, so he wasn't there. We don't know when he's returning. But I know the Pistons did pick up D Rose. Y'all know D Rose was with the Timberwolves. I don't know why he got traded, but he had 18 points and 9 assists. And then Jamal, he had 32, 23. And 4 blocks. Like, he had a great game. I feel like Draymond, however you say it, he's a good player. I feel like he deserved more. I feel like he should be on a better team, if you ask me. Like, he's a great player. But they took that W. And yeah. Moving on. Y'all know the Grizzlies. They played the Nets. It was 134 to 133. I believe it went into overtime. Y'all know they just picked up Jay Crowder. Jay Crowder only had 6 points, but he did win the game winner. So, I mean, I guess that's all that matters. But he did play a whole 38 minutes and only ended up with 38 points. So, that means he only had 3 points in the first 4 quarters. But, I mean, hey. Kyrie did have 37 points. I don't know how the Nets let that slip past them, but they took that ill. And then, y'all know, the Bulls and the Hornets played. It was 126 to 125. Y'all know the Hornets did just pick up Terry Rozier. Terry Rozier did start. I know that's what he wanted from the Celtics, and now he got it. But he only got 7 points in 30 minutes. Maybe he'll get better. But that was the first game, so maybe he had to, like, warm up to his new team. But I didn't really watch that game because I don't really know nobody on the Bulls but Levine and Otto Porter. So, can't really say much about that game. But that's basically it for week 1. It was a good week. And then we got to talk about the Nationals. Y'all know the Nationals is in the World Series. We did fuck up over the weekend. Hopefully, we can pull through the next 2 games and win. But I'm praying, and yeah, but thank y'all for watching. I'll be back for week 2, and